Hello and welcome. This is Vanessa Growlish, and today we're going to do the fan review of The Queen's Gambit. Yes. So The Queen's Gambit is a show in Netflix that shows the life of Beth Harmon. Beth Harmon is just basically this chess prodigy girl that her main goal in the whole movie, well, in the whole series, to put it away, is to go to Russia and basically become a world chess champion. Beautiful, the show. Why do I like this show so much? Well, let's start with the, the main actress. Well, this the show is based in a book, which Walter Tevis, I think that's the name, wrote it in 1983 or published it. And basically, the drama, it's not a drama, I wouldn't call it a drama, but it's a good show that basically is in the mid 1950s, 1960s. And it's just beautiful because you could see that she has also an alcohol and a drug dependency. But I think like the best part of the show is how straight this woman and how smart she is. And I think like a lot of people like to watch her, and then she's just so beautiful. The dresses they show, it's a beautiful show. I'm going to tell you, I never watch things on Netflix because I'm scared that this is going to be a black hole where I'm going to get in and I'm never going to get out. But I have seen like everyone's like The Queen's Gambit. And then I had one of my friends that I really admire, and she's like, oh, I watch. And I said, what? If she watched, it must be good. And I went ahead and watched it, and I was fascinated. What were the best parts? Okay, so Beth Harmon, she's an orphan. And I'm not going to tell you what the show, because I want you to watch it and enjoy it. But there's a part that she's with her new mom. Basically, their job is to, go to these tournaments and make money. And the mom says, and she's like, oh, Beth, out of the $500, and then she starts doing the math of the expenses. And then she's like, we have this much left. It was like 300 and something. And then she's like, I feel that I should get a 10%, basically like a fee, right? Like for being her manager. And then Beth turns around and you're thinking, oh my God, she's going to get upset. She's going to tell her something. And then she goes, why not 15 instead? Like how incredible that it was, just so straightforward, so easy, no drama. I cannot stand shows, and I'm sorry, whoever is fan of The Crown or like anything like novelas, anything that is like passive aggressiveness and drama, and I have a hidden agenda, and I'm going to say, I'm like thinking, why, if I have already real life, I just don't enjoy watching it. But that doesn't mean that I don't see the value of, the historical part and so on. But let's going back to The Queen's Gambit. This is the type of show that is very straightforward, and I really enjoy it. It has really good music too, and the actress is beyond beautiful. Her name is Anya Taylor-Joy. She was actually born in Argentina, but her parents, I believe they're British, for what I read. I'm not sure, but she actually speaks Spanish, and she's just beautiful. And the whole show, you see how, she has a really high IQ, a really high emotional IQ. And of course, the dependency of the drugs and alcohol kind of like affect that. I do think though that which I did not like that part. The show was great, but I felt that there was a little bit of glorification of the drug dependency or like, the alcohol. There's a little bit more damage of what it was showing the show. But I think I also understand the point of whoever was doing the show, that wasn't really what they wanted to go through, like the bad things of alcohol, her throwing up and being, no. I just think like they felt like it was important to notice that she was a very smart woman, but addiction is always something that can get you smart or not, because, it's a problem. But she was able to control it. And I think that it was very well done, but I feel that yes, just in general, alcohol and pills, will not make you a world champion. Let's put it that way. But going back to The Queen's Gambit, the other scene that I love, that one and another one that I'm going to tell you, was there was this chess champion that he goes to the house and whatever, they're working together for her to become the champion in Russia. And they have a night together, and then he's like sitting next to her, and then she's like reading her little chess book. She's so cute. And then he's like, Beth, should I leave or should I stay? And she just looks at the book, looks at him, she's like, do whatever you want. I was like, oh my gosh, she's so good. And I don't remember what happens if he stays or if he leaves. I think they cut the scene there. Then the other scene, and I think this is when I was like, oh, I love this show. There is a part, she has to learn Russian because her goal again is to go to Russia and, you know, become the world champion. And she's in the elevator and the Russians that she's competing with, the thing is she's by herself. And then the Russians that she, you know, she goes to Russia at the end and they all play together. You know, it's like they have like these three Russian brains trying to like, you know, when she's actually by herself, but they show like they have the Americans, you know, trying to help her over the phone, like, oh, you could do this move, blah, blah, blah. So it was very nice because it kind of like glorify what teamwork can do. And I felt that, you know, when everyone has the same goal, when everyone says, yes, let's do it, then, you know, you get really good outcomes. There was a part then in the elevator and she had learned Russian, but they don't know that she learned Russian. And they start talking about her, but they don't know that she's in the back. So they start speaking in Russian and, you know, she's understanding the whole thing. They're like, oh, I heard she's a drunk. I heard she's a drogie, blah, 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 blah. And then one of the Russians tells the other guy, very arrogant, like, oh, you're going to destroy her. And then he goes and then he's like, well, I think she's going to, basically he says like, I think she's going to be a strong opponent because this is all what she has. If she loses, she loses everything. Basically saying that she's nothing other than, if she doesn't win this, she loses everything. And that's when you're like, go and kick his ass. And I'm not going to tell you what happens, but that's exactly how you feel in the scene. You're like, go and kick his ass. And you're kind of feeling like she needs to win. This is all what she has. And it's just beautiful. The show also reflects on the part that, you know, she's a woman and people, instead of seeing her as a player, of course, you know, gender always comes into place. But I mean, it was mentioned, but they didn't like milk it, which is good because at the end, I think like the whole thing about the show is like how you can be passionate about something and then do everything that you have and do whatever it takes just to, you know, reach that goal. The Queen's Gambit is actually, let me just go ahead and share it right here. The Queen's is the first move. Let me just show you. It's one of the, okay, so the name Queen's Gambit, okay, is the chess opening that starts with the move D4, D5, and then C4. And then it says here, it is one of the oldest opening and is still commonly played today. It is traditionally described as a gambit because white appears to sacrifice the C pawn. I'm like really like ignoring about chess. However, this could be considered a misnomer as black cannot retain the pawn without incurring a disadvantage. As you can see here, this show is just all about strategy. Chess is just basically, about figuring out like, okay, if I do this, then if, then, if, then, if, then. Basically, you know, like a brain of a programmer, right? Trying to figure out an if-then statement and a truth table together. But it was really good. I hope you maybe enjoy it. What I like about it, they're really short episodes. And they're not, I mean, there is drama, but it's not that drama like, you know, like, two women getting upset at each other or a man and a woman getting upset. It's actually more like very refreshing, I will say. It's a really refreshing series because you feel that she has a goal and she wants to do this and it's very realistic. I really enjoy it. So I hope you guys enjoy it too. I hope you enjoy this mini fan review and I'll see you next time.